Welcome to Limor TV, the place to be to learn about money and get inspired to take small steps to improve your finances. I'm not a financial planner, but I'll show you what I've learned. In today's episode, I'm going to be explaining the compound interest formula. Come on, this will be magical. Basically, compound interest is your original investment plus its reinvested earnings coupled with time. The more time you have, the more opportunity you have to grow the investment. Let's take a look at a basic example. If I were to take $1,000 and invest it at 5% interest, at the end of the year, I would have $1,050. If I were to take that whole amount, reinvest it again for another year at 5% interest, at the end of the year, I would have $1,102 and some change. If I were to take that whole amount and reinvest it again, at the end of the third year, I would have $1,157 and some change. Hope you're still with me, but let me explain how the magic of compound interest works in comparison with simple interest. With simple interest, I would take that same $1,000 and, like in my first example, I would invest it at 5% interest for 1 year. At the end of the year, I would have $1,050. If I were then to take just the $1,000 and reinvest it, not the $50, at the end of year two, I would have $1,000 plus $50 in interest plus $50 from the year before. So I would have $1,100. Again, if I were to take just the base $1,000 and reinvest it, at the end of the third year, I would have $1,050. Plus, I would have $50 from year two and $50 from year one. Altogether, I would have $1,150. If you compare that to my example from the compound interest, you'll see I'll have had made $7 more in the compound interest. But if we were to add in the power of time, you'll be able to see how significant compound interest really is. So let's say I took that $1,000 with compound interest at 5%, for over 30 years. At the end of the 30 years, I would have $4,321 and some change. But if I were to take the simple interest approach, after 30 years, I would only have $2,500. You can see that's quite a big difference. Now, what I'm really hoping is that we're all saving on a regular basis. We're not just saving a once baseline amount and then letting it grow for years on end. So let's take a look at what happens if we were to contribute a bit more every single year. What if I were to save $1,000 and every year add another $1,000 to it, and I did that for 30 years? At 5% interest, at the end of the 30 years, I would have $69,760 and some change. So if you think about it, I actually only took $30,000 out of my accounts to put into savings, but overall, my savings more than doubled. This is where retirement comes into play, and you start to hear people saying, you should start saving early. Let's do another example. If I were to put $200 aside every single month at the same 5% interest, at the end of the 40-year duration, I would find that I'd have over $304,000. I think that's pretty amazing. Essentially, the more time you have, the more ability you have to grow your investment. That brings me to today's tweetable. With compound interest, the magic factor is time. Now, of course, I've simplified that example a little bit. Obviously, putting $200 away every single month from when you're 25 to when you're 65 doesn't really take into consideration what's happening in your life. All of us in our 20s are making less money, and it feels like we've got more challenging priorities. Our first emergency fund, saving for our first home, and then of course, yeah, that retirement thing. Here's my challenge to you. I want you to go online and look up a compound interest calculator. There's quite a few of them. And then play around. I want you to figure out how just a little bit of savings every single month now can make a really big difference to you later on. One other thing to take into consideration is that now people are living longer. If I retire at 65, I'm hoping to live another 30 years till I'm 95. That's a lot of time that I need to make sure that I'm financially secure. So, probably important that I start saving for my retirement now. Did you like this video? Did you learn something? Subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And if you want even more tips and tricks and inspiration to make your financial journey fun and exciting,
come on over to limormarkman.money and sign up for email updates.
Remember, I'm not here to change who you are or how you live your life. I just have strategies to make you even more financially fabulous. And you don't have to change what you're doing all that much. Be proud that you're learning and taking small steps to improve your finances. It will give you greater confidence and peace of mind. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you next time on Limor TV. According to Albert Einstein, compound interest is the most...